Happy Saturday morning, everybody. Mike here again with some things to think about on this Saturday morning. You know, with the easing of some of the social distancing restrictions this week, again, we're asked to still keep social distancing. We can just go to more stores and maybe be in groups of 10 while we're social distancing. But with the ease of social distancing requirements just a little bit this week, I've been asked quite a few times, so when do we get to start just going back to church like normal again? And I don't know when that's going to be. I think it's still going to be some time. It's going to be a while still before we can do church like we're used to doing church. And whenever I share that with people, people are visibly upset. And I understand that. I understand that. We miss being able to meet together like we normally do. But I want to try to remind you again this morning of how truly blessed we truly are as Christians in our country, that we can gather together, worship God, we can sing songs as loud as we want, we can sit around eating donuts, drinking coffee, we can listen to the Word of God preached, and we have really no fear while we're doing that. The coronavirus has hit the world, and it is impacting the persecuted church in significant ways, much more significant than we have felt. There's a story this week out of Indonesia of a family who was part of the underground church. Indonesia is a country controlled by Muslim extremists in a lot of different areas of that country. And this family was simply at home worshiping God together pretty quietly, according to reports, because of fear. This family that was part of an underground church could not meet together with the other Christians like they normally did because of the social distancing requirements of their government. And so, like we have been doing on Sunday mornings, they met together as a family and quietly worshiped God in their own home when there was a pounding on the door. And there was a Muslim man standing at the door with one of the neighborhood watch leaders. And they commanded that this Christian family stop worshiping God in their home because it was against the law of their community. They could not hold a church service in their home, a Christian church service. And when the Christian tried to just explain, we are simply following the laws of our country and being socially distant from everybody else, and we are in the privacy of our own home, they were threatened with a return of a mob if they didn't stop. You see, again, I understand we're frustrated that we can't just go to church like normal. We're frustrated we can't do the normal things that we do in our country. But we are not at the point where we have neighbors pounding on our doors, carrying clubs and sticks, threatening to bring back mobs to hurt us and kill us if we don't stop worshiping at home. So today, again, as you may feel frustrated with the coronavirus, you may feel frustrated with all that's going on in our community, and I understand those frustrations, remember how blessed you are that you can freely worship at home with your family with no fear, with no threat of violence from your neighbors. Remember those who are part of the persecuted church around the world and the courage that it takes for them every single time they gather together just as a family in their living room to quietly sing a song, to read a Bible, and to pray. Pray for our persecuted brothers and sisters today. As a reminder, I love you. Most importantly, God loves you. I'll see you next time.